I'm Dr. Michael Hyman with LA Sexual Health. You can go visit the website, lasexualhealth.com. Today we're going to talk about different ways of treating low testosterone. So you've been told that, you know, your testosterone level is low or it's in the low normal range. You've been given a trial of testosterone injections, because that's my approach. I find that the best way is to just get some trial doses in the office of pure testosterone cypionate, as we call it, about 200 milligrams every 2 weeks for about a month, and say you come back and tell me, hey, I feel great, this has improved my sex drive, my mood is better, I'm more active, I'm going to the gym, I'm more motivated, it's just a big boost in my quality of life. We're then going to have a conversation about your best approach for long-term treatment. The first thing, let me just get out of the way, there is no oral treatment. You can't swallow a pill. I know that many of you ask me about the supplements that you see online. You go to Amazon or whatever, and it'll say, you know, testosterone supplements or testosterone booster. Honestly, it's all mostly plant extracts or some other variant, and it is not testosterone. And here's why. The reality is that when you swallow a pill, or frankly, you take anything down the gastrointestinal tract, the first place that substance is going from your gastrointestinal tract, your stomach or your small intestine, through the wall, absorbed by the bloodstream, it goes directly to the liver. That is its first stop for everything. So we call this first pass metabolism. Some drugs do fine with first pass metabolism, but in the case of testosterone, it's completely deactivated. There is no activity, it's broken down completely, and so you cannot take oral testosterone because it will be completely inactivated by the liver. Therefore, you have to bypass first pass metabolism, and the only way to do that is to go through the skin. And so how can we administer something through skin? Well, we can give you a shot, obviously. There are absorbable gels, creams, salves, whatever you want to call them. And then there are what we call subcutaneous pellets. So I'm going to talk about all three of those things. So the shots are, as I said in the beginning of this video, are great for just getting your levels right up there. Very dependable, it's gonna get it at a normal level, and it's gonna, you know, you're gonna feel it probably within 24 hours if you do respond. And in that regard, it's great. You do have to get a shot, which isn't so great. You do have to have it administered. Some people can do it themselves, other people have to come to the office and have it done. It is an intramuscular injection. So it's not just going, you know, superficially under the skin. It's got to go deep into either your deltoid muscle or your gluteal muscle in your butt, whatever. It's got to be intramuscular. The other downside is, of course, that it's not particularly long lasting. So in the case of, say, 200 milligram dose, you're going to need to get a repeat shot every 2 weeks. Now, some doctors might, you know, alter that schedule. Some people will do once a week a lower dose, or once a month a higher dose. But make no mistake, there is a real kind of peak trough phenomenon. In other words, you get this stuff, it goes in quickly into your bloodstream, but after, say, you know, 6, 7, 8 days, it's going to start falling off also pretty quickly. So you do get this kind of like high low experience, and a lot of people don't like that. You can try to fiddle with it by changing the timing schedule or the dosing schedule, but it really is a problem for long-term therapy. So then there's the what we call the topicals, and that means like skin creams or gels or salve, whatever you want to call that. Now, there are two that are FDA approved, and you need a prescription. And by the way, any prescription for testosterone has to be written on a DEA schedule three, I believe it is, prescription pad. That means that it is basically like a narcotic. I mean, it's a controlled substance. You can't have it called in. It has to be on a physical DEA pad prescription, and that's a little inconvenient. But in any event, that's our government hard at work for us. And so you have to take that to a pharmacy. And if you're going to get those, either of those two FDA approved gels, one is called Testim and the other one is called Androgel. You have to put that on every day. And it can vary. It's a little tricky because some people have different absorption rates. So you're kind of trying to figure out like what the right amount is. I mean, there's a standard, but it's rarely the same for everybody. You gotta, you know, and then if you're not getting the right levels, you're not sure. So you have to get your blood drawn and find out, is it because you're not responding or is it because you are getting the levels? But it can be confusing. So I'm not a huge fan of those, but you know, if that's best for you, then that's what you can get. You have to remember to put it on every day. You have to be very careful because if you don't wash your hands carefully and then you pick up your little kid, you're gonna transfer them some doses of testosterone and that could be really bad news for your little kid. So be very aware of that. And what else? So that's the topicals. There is some people will go for like a compounding pharmacy. And the only thing you have to be careful about, if your doctor has a relationship and they really trust that compounding pharmacy, oh, that's one thing. But you just have to be aware they're all different. They all formulate differently. Some of them use, you know, additives and, you know, there's nothing going to be as safe as the FDA-approved Testim or Androgel. Once you start to go outside of those, it's unregulated. So you're never really sure what you're getting. So be very mindful of that. Lastly, there are the subcutaneous pellets. And I am a fan of the pellets because they're long lasting. So you can receive these pellets under the skin and they'll carry you out anywhere from 6 weeks to 3 months. So you only need to do it, you know, 3 or 4 times a year. That's very convenient. You just come to the office and it takes about 7 minutes and then you're on your way. It also keeps your levels very steady over that time period until, you know, until it starts to wear off. But that, like I said, that could be 6 weeks, 8 weeks, even up to 3 months before you start to notice like, oh yeah, it's coming down and I'm ready for my next round of pellet placement. So those are the three approaches. And if you have any questions, I'm on lasexualhealth.com. You can reach out to us by email. And of course, you can come in for consultation. I also do Skype or actually HIPAA compliant, basically privacy compliant online consultations. Okay, thank you.